Hello there. Don't you just love this time of year? Wrapping presents for the family. My grandchildren are growing up so quickly now. Little Ella has a tattoo. And Jack started vaping. Where does the time go? They keep saying to me, Grandad, don't you know it's Baggy Hi-Fi time? And I don't know what they mean. Still, I think they still like gramophone records. So that's what I've bought them this year. For Ella, I've got this Shape Up and Dance with Felicity Kendall. And for Jack, Hits for a Truck Driving Man by Big Dave and the Tennessee Tailgaters. I can't wait to see their little faces on Christmas morning. Greetings, cats and kittens. Welcome once again to Baggy Hi-Fi, this YouTube channel devoted to record collecting and the vinyl community here in the UK. I hope you're all keeping well. We're now towards the end of December. Christmas is next Friday. We're in the dark days of December where we don't get too much daylight and maybe not too much good news either, because we just heard yesterday that the southern parts of the UK are going into a new restriction of Tier 4. Which is means I think that families can only get together for one day over Christmas. Here in the north, we're in Tier 3, which is still very restricted anyway. But I'm sure we'll work our way through the holiday season. This video is quite a mixture, quite a mixed bag. In my last video, I did show all CDs for the first time ever, and it was a video concentrating on music to listen to while driving in the car. And a few of you commented that you wouldn't mind seeing a few more CDs. So I've decided just to show CDs which aren't available on vinyl, or at least are difficult to get on vinyl. And the first thing I'm going to show you, first batch of music, is another release on the Grapefruit label, the excellent Grapefruit label. Distributed by Cherry Red, and this is another great clamshell box set. I did show a few of these in the last video, the ones for 1967, 68 and 69, I think 1970 as well. Well, this one concentrates on that great year for British pop, 1966. It's called A Slight Disturbance in My Mind, the British Proto-Psychedelic Sounds of 1966. Now, 66 was a year, certainly kind of a hinge year. The Beatles probably at their peak, just about, and a lot of other bands were as well. Now, like the other collections, this has a lovely booklet, Grapefruit label, lots of notes on each track, three CDs, some well-known artists and some definitely not well-known artists as well. There are some classics on here like Making Time by The Creation and Painter Man, My Friend Jack by The Smoke, The Yardbirds, The Action, I love that track, I'll Keep Holding On, The Fleur-de-Lis, The Misunderstood, The Pretty Things, The Kinks. It's a fantastic collection. I've been listening to this one in the car, and probably, you know, if I was going to recommend just one of the Grapefruit box sets, it would be this one, 1966, Slight Disturbance in My Mind, and the next one, the 1967 collection. So extremely highly recommended if you like British beat, pop music, freak beat, early psych. Great collection. Heartily recommended. So that's the last CD I'm going to show in this video. Next one is another one from the 60s, but an earlier period. This is a Joe Meek collection, or a collection of his productions, and this is Hits from 304 Holloway Road. If you know a little bit about Joe Meek, the incredibly inspired producer from the early 60s, all of his recordings were, at least the, maybe some of his late 50s recordings weren't recorded at this studio, but his studio was in a house above a shop on 304 Holloway Road. And what he did with those, you know, limited means was just amazing, really. This is a good collection. John Layton is on here, Johnny Remember Me, The Tornadoes, Telstar, of course. But there are some lesser well-known ones on here as well. Girl Bride by Jeff Goddard. That's a great one. I do like Jeff Goddard with his kind of lispy Irish accent. Moon Trekkers, Night of the Vampire, fantastic instrumental, real spooky one. Yeah, it's a good collection here. I will be doing a video on Joe Meek Productions. And I did watch recently, I think it was recorded, made in about 12 years ago, a feature film, British feature film, about the life of Joe Meek called Telstar. And it's quite a good film, especially the character who plays Heinz, which was Joe Meek's protege and boyfriend. But it does feature, I must warn you, James Corden. Maybe you like James Corden, but he does great on me. But James Corden plays the drummer Clem Cattini of the Tornadoes, and he's quite a prominent character in the film. But it's worth a watch, and I think it's on, I did watch it on YouTube. So that's another Joe Meek collection. It's from 304 Holloway Road, and the label is one I've never heard of, called Wax Love. Could be a bootleg, I'm not sure. But nice pressing, nice loud sound. And another sticking in the early 60s, this is another one in the Remembering series that Decca put out in the late 70s, collecting some early 60s British beat music. This is Jet Harris and Tony Meehan. And Jet Harris and Tony Meehan were members of The Shadows, who left quite early on. They had a less wholesome image. I think you'll agree that The Shadows did have a very wholesome image, probably partly because they were associated with squeaky clean Cliff Richard. But I always thought that Jet Harris had a kind of a more of a sinister look about him, with those smoky eyes. Jet Harris played, was a bass player, and Tony Meehan was a drummer. And they put out quite a few, they had a few hits with particularly Applejack and Diamonds in the early 60s, recorded for Decca. This compilation is excellent and includes some vocal tracks, but mainly instrumental. Very, very nice. Jet Harris plays a kind of lead guitar version of the bass guitar, playing his elaborate looking Burns bass guitar. So yeah, fantastic music, British music from the early 60s. Jet Harris and Tony Meehan. I'm going to do a needle drop of one of the tracks from this album now. I paid a visit recently just to my local shop, music shop, which I've mentioned before, Steeltown Records, and looking through the racks, I wasn't really finding anything, but it was one of those days where I really wanted to buy a couple of records at least. So I thought, yeah, let's listen to a bit of new wave power pop from the late 70s. So I picked up this Labour of Lust by Nick Lowe, and I've never owned really a Nick Lowe album before, despite, you know, liking listening to him on the radio, especially the hits that he had, you know, Cruel to Be Kind, I Love the Sound of Breaking Glass, all that kind of stuff from the late 70s. Never really followed his career really after that, but I know he went in quite a country direction. But yeah, venerable producer and songwriter. How could you not like a chappy with that kind of smile? And there he is. What a long lankin he was. But yeah, this is a really good, I think it's his second solo album on the Radar label. This is only £4 and it's in really, really good condition. I enjoyed listening to it. It's kind of sort of crackles with vitality and, you know, excellent songwriting. Something that's kind of occurred to me watching VC vinyl community videos is that a lot of Americans talk about new wave, And sometimes they mention, you know, in the same breath, bands like Cheap Trick and Tom Petty, but that's to me, that's just sort of trad rock. I guess this is more new wave, and it's, you know, as opposed to punk, which is much more basic, much more aggressive. This is, you know, short, sharp tunes recorded in the late 70s. That kind of, this is music which I regard as new wave. Just a minor point there. And this next record was bought on the same day, and this was only fiver, I think. I used to own this. This is Elvis Costello's third album, Armed Forces. And I thought, well, let's get this one as well. This is also from 1979. It's produced by Nick Lowe. This is not the version that has the fold-out sleeve, which was designed by Barney Bubbles and the French Bazooka Graphic Design Collective. That's some of their art, though, on the back there. I always like that sleeve. But these are really, this is probably Elvis Costello at his peak. It's a later pressing. Don't think it is on the Radar label. It's on the F Beat label. And yeah, cheap record, but I played it and it just sounds fantastic. It's in good condition. Some Cos Oliver's Army is on this one. Yeah, I regard both this kind of the Nick Lowe album and the Elvis Costello album as sort of Saturday afternoon albums, kind of chirpy, good time music. But the lyrics, I have to say, on this album are very sort of paranoid and quite political as well. Elvis, I read, talking about this album, Elvis Costello said that he was, at the time, he believed he knew everything at the age of 24. And there was still that revisionist attitude, even though Elvis Costello wasn't really punk rock, of kind of leaving the old school behind. And there is a story I saw, an interview recently with Elvis Costello, where he confronted Robert Plant and just kind of just went up to him and just said, "Stairway to Heaven," as if, you know, that was just never going to be listened to again. But yeah, Elvis Costello, probably, you know, at his finest on Armed Forces from 1979. Going backwards now and into more folky territory. This week I was able to, on my day off, to go to Kiwi Trading in Hartlepool. It's an antique place which I've mentioned before, and they have lots and lots of very good records. I always like to visit that shop, and I bought two albums there. This is the first one. This is Steel Ice Band's second album, Pleased to See the King, and it's an original on the B&C label. It's in very nice condition. It has this Hessian sleeve, or Hessian effect. Just feel the how rustic that is. Very, very nice. And there's a, also in here, there is a lyric sheet. If I can remove it from this Hessian cover. Nice cream paper there. Yeah, so I always think that Steel Ice Band don't seem to be as highly regarded as Fairport Convention. It's possibly because they had a few hits with, you know, All Around My Hat and Gaudete in the later years after this album. And they were also produced by Mike Batt. And there is a story that Steel Ice Band featured in a Wombles video as a favour to Mike Batt, the creator of the musical version of the Wombles. And it was Steel Ice Band who appeared, I think, on Top of the Pops wearing the Womble suits. But anyway, you know, Tim Hart, Matty Pryor, Ashley Hutchins, this is that era of the band, and this is a wonderful album of traditional folk tunes. There's no drumming on this album. It does have a mournful, spooked sound to it, especially on tracks like Boys of Bedlam, which is about the infamous asylum. It's a very great record, which I think has influenced a lot of current folk rock, British folk rock revivalists. And talking of which, I've got another album here by The Left Outside, and this is released just a couple of months ago. This is their latest album by this duo, Are You Sure I Was There? And it's released on, it's a joint release between the British label Cardinal Fuzz and Feeding Tube Records, Byron Coley's label. Nice package, as ever, with this band. Alison Cotton and Mark Nicholas. Alison Cotton's voice I'm really warming to. She plays viola as well. There's a nice label as well, and a lyric sheet. Yes, a very, this one really is growing on me now. It's one of those slow burners of an album. Everything progresses at a slow pace. And what's nice about this one compared to previous Left Outsides albums is that there are some field recordings on here. Recorded at Lake Bolsena, Italy, Binham Priory, Norfolk, some lovely church bells, St Mary's Church, Great Massingham in Norfolk, and Lloyd Park, Walthamstow, London. Walking, you can hear the field recording of people walking through crunchy leaves. So this is definitely an album which will be enjoyed in the autumn time, and also it's a winter album as well. It's very, very mournful and slow, and definitely conjures up the English landscape and bare trees, etc. So yeah, highly recommended. The Left Outsides, Are You Sure I Was There, from 2020. Now, the other record I bought at Kiwi Trading was one I've been looking for a while, and it's one I was just about to buy a reissued version of, but this is an original of a Paisley Underground classic album by the 3 O'Clock, 16 Tambourines. The band are the 3 O'Clock. This is their first album. They're from LA, and Michael Quercio, the diminutive fey-voiced singer of this band, coined the term Paisley Underground for this sort of loose collective of bands from LA in the early 80s, which included Rain Parade, the Dream Syndicate, Long Riders maybe as well. Again, I promise to do a video in 2021 on the Paisley Underground, but this is a really good album. It's a bit more sort of power poppy, certainly 60s jangly influence on than their second album, which I've shown earlier on, and that was called Arrive Without Travelling. But yeah, this is their first. It includes Jet Fighter. They never really received the recognition that they deserved, although I believe that Prince was a fan, because as you know, the Bangles recorded Manic Monday by Prince, and I believe Prince told the Bangles that yeah, he was a fan of the 3 O'Clock, and I am too. So I'm going to play a needle drop from this album. And just before I do that, I just mentioned that they do a really great version of one of the Bee Gees' psych period songs, In My Own Time. So yeah, the 3 O'Clock, 16 Tambourines, from 1983. Final batch of records I'm going to show are all 7-inch singles, 45s. I was on my day off this week and went into a charity shop wasn't expecting to find very much, and there was a box of singles tucked away, and the majority of them obviously come from the same person who was, must have been buying singles in the late 70s and early 80s, so I did buy a few of them, and some of them actually are from the 70s as well. So this one is quite unusual. It's a maxi single by The Association, and I've shown some albums by The Association before, the great Sunshine Pop Harmony band from the 60s. So this is released on Warner Brother Records, and it features their three of their big hits. Along comes Mary, Cherish, and Windy. So couldn't refuse that for a pound. This next one is also a maxi single with three tracks, and it's on the Fly label, and it's by Procol Harum, and it features A Whiter Shade of Pale, and also on the B-side, A Salty Dog and Homburg. Homburg is probably my favourite Procol Harum track. A nice brown label there for the Fly record company. So yeah, three of Procol Harum's greatest tracks for a pound. This one I couldn't pass by either. This is a Mick Ronson single. I think the A-side is Love Me Tender from his album Slaughter on 10th Avenue. Fantastic album he did around about the time. I think he was still in Bowie's Spiders from Mars. But the B-side is the track I really like, again from that album, Only After Dark. Great glam track. Moving on to the early 80s, Altered Images' first single, which I've always been a fan of and never had a copy of it. Dead Pop Stars, produced by Steve Severin from Susie and the Banshees. And I always thought this one does sound rather kind of goth and Susie and the Banshee-esque, except it has the sweet voice of Claire Grogan on it, of course. From around about the same time, another one for a pound, Never Stop by Echo and the Bunnymen. And the other track is, the B-side is Heads Will Roll. What label is this on? Corova, I guess. Yeah, Corova. Now this one, final one, couldn't quite believe my eyes. It's on the Vertigo label, and it's by Beggar's Opera, who made, I think, two or three very good prog albums. So there is the famous Vertigo Swirl label. I looked this one up on Discogs, and it usually goes for about £25, this one. So I do like this record as well. It's a sort of a wah-wah, chugging, Hammond organ prog tune, which couldn't have come from any other era than about 1970. I think this is from about 1970, is it? Yeah. I think it must be on German Vertigo. Das Label for Progressive Music, Pop Music. And this back sleeve shows a Pato album, Warhorse album, May Blitz, and of course Black Sabbath Paranoid album. So that's Beggar's Opera with Saraband. I'm going to do a needle drop of that. The same charity shop did have a copy of Paranoid on by Black Sabbath on Vertigo, of course, but it was too beaten up, and I think that's probably one which is much easier to find than this one by Beggar's Opera. So that's the end of this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you as ever for your subscriptions and comments, which I do enjoy replying to. This won't be the last Baggy Hi-Fi video for 2020. There will be another one just before the end of the year. By popular request, well, two people have asked for it anyway. I'm going to do a compilation of all the introductions to the Baggy Hi-Fi videos throughout 2020. But if you're not interested in that one, I do wish you all a Merry Christmas, and let's hope for a happier and healthier 2021 when it comes along. So thanks for watching. Bye for now.